Lockhart once said that people are under the misconception that mathematics is useful to society. There are applications of mathematics that are indeed useful to society, but the essence of mathematics isn't really that. It's exploration. How it started out was just logic. You know, it was Plato wondering what things are, you know, what forms are. Plato's forms, the allegory of the cave, those were the beginnings of mathematics. It's organic. It truly is organic. It's not this cold, relentless, calculating monster. You know, it's people tackling new problems in the way that they want to see those new problems solved. In graph theory, very recent breakthroughs have been made that I'm learning about today. I always thought that mathematics was solved so long ago. And the more and more I go upwards, the more and more I realize it's this very alive, very kicking thing where people are making discoveries daily. You know, people are publishing still. And that's fascinating. The reason that I study math is because I like seeing the patterns that other people use to build their world. You start looking at famous mathematicians like Gauss, right, or like Euler. They invented new techniques to look at things in a new perspective and develop conclusions that weren't available before. And that's really cool, because you can apply that to anything. If you have the ability to step back and look at something from a completely new angle, you can come at a conclusion that no one has ever seen before. There's this great essay called A Mathematician's Lament, and in it, the author goes through all the ways of which you could teach math and the horrible, horrible mess that we're forcing our high schoolers to go through. And the paper goes through and makes this excellent point. Let's say someone else said that, oh, well, why do I care about the philosophy side of math if the applied side of math doesn't matter? It's the same reason we teach literature. Not everyone who's forced to read through Shakespeare isn't expected to become a new author. You know, we teach it to provoke the ability of the student to perhaps explore that avenue for himself. How math is being taught takes out all the wonder that is prevalent in upper level math. Everything that you've been working with has been solved already. You're essentially instructed to become a machine that takes in input, writes down some stuff on a piece of paper, and presents output. Right? That's not very interesting, and you can't really use that. And what it does is it takes all the expression that you can find within math and it rips it away, which is really unfortunate, because there's so much expression you can do in mathematics. And you don't really need all that much infrastructure to appreciate it either. Just like how an artist would use metal to build something for other people to look at and see and admire. You can use something that's not very flexible and build something that's mind-blowing, that's perception, you know, that changes your perception, that changes the way you look at the world. And that's math. Math can do that. My name is Ahmad Jarara, and I study mathematics at Binghamton University.